Gela, please tell us your name.
Gela Chen Songruanang.
His Holiness the Dalai Lama asked us to record your experiences so that we can share your memories with many generations of Tibetans, the Chinese, and the rest of the world. Your memories will help us to document the true history, culture, and beliefs of the Tibetan people. Do you give your permission for the Tibet Oral History Project to use this interview?
You can use it.
Thank you for offering to share our story with us, your story with us. During this interview, if you wish to take a break or stop at any time, please let me know.
You don't have to be a break. Take a break.
If you do not wish to answer a question or talk about something, let me know. If this interview was shown in Tibet or China, would this be a problem for you?
No problem at all. Can show it anywhere.
We are honored to record your story and appreciate your participation in this project.
Thank you.
Gela, we would like to cover many topics, but I would like to invite you to tell me what are some of the topics you wish us to be sure to cover in this interview.
I would like to talk to you about the deception of the Chinese and also the suppression by the Chinese.
And what about your childhood? Would you be interested in sharing a little bit about growing up in Tibet?
I'll tell you, since I was about 8 years, I used to go grazing the animals like goat, sheep, and yak. Mm. And I was not a servant to anybody else, but the animals belonged to us.
Mm. And how many homes were in your village?
In my village, there were about 14 to 15 homes.
And can you tell us a little bit about your family? Who was in your family, and were they well off or not so well off? What was the circumstances?
Uh, we were middle class family, and there were two sons, a daughter, and our parents.
Did you go to any school when you were a little boy?
Again, I come to change you in because you loved the pay, you know.
Oh, poor old people, man.
I did not go to school in Tibet. There was a school the Chinese had started, but my parents did not send me. It's because if the parents sent me, the Chinese would take me to China, and I would be separated from my parents.
Can you tell us a little bit about your experience taking care of the animals?
And gala chundu gane ya tanda semjen chogu yorwa. And bi korla pe singo nang sa gala nyam nyong bi korla ya.
Tade jada jadi bundu ta je sabar je. Jada jadi bundu dengan jauh mara korban dengan tanjang mana.
I do not remember much about those days, but I remember that I was not sent alone, but I went along with many colleagues.
Oh, many other children or older people?
And eh, rokpa donzo pugu pugu chikpa dende re ya mi gamba nyamdo pegi yo simjin
chong. Mi gamba re, pugu yo ma, mi gamba nyamdo re abu tanya
la. No, they were much older people. You know, the children were sent along with the older people.
And how large were the herds of animals?
And a simjin do zu mangnyu kha zhe si yo re chaga du de gan ne.
Ru zhe na ba zhe dong zhe de. Ben zhe ma. Na chong la de mi shun lu zhe ne.
There were about 1,000 sheep, mm-hmm. and about 3 people went to graze them.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us what your job was when you were a little bit older as taking care of the sheep? What did you do?
Ane ta kala thangbo de chinji ruwa kong le kesa di ya zlang du ga ne ane lu nyam do phegi yor wal ane lengge khare khare yor lu choga du du ga ne
ta lu da lu choga do le ane di ya anga thon do no ya ta lengge de ko to de a gung ga yana a thong do gung ga cha ro wa an do go ro wa ta pho ga sin da ri ya ane thong do sin pa de ne ane mata chura ani loge ani yana namo so te so de ani ani tama du ada na adure ada tema so so ne wada chonde ju wa ko ada chonde do sa de dai pa do ta pa do bu de ne ba chonde che che ni pa du de tama ra pa do che de che ki ni che a chu wa de tama de ka ya pa do ya ga wa chu ko do ta ta ma chura de ga lo wa cha do
I remember I was about 13 years old when I once went on a trade. It was in winter and I went to Pobra. And we took butter, cheese, and fur of the animals to them while we battered them for champa, grains, and peas.
Was this Pokhara, did you say? Pokhara?
Pari.
Oh, Pari.
Pari dore, Pobra dore.
Pobra.
The place is called Pobra Sangaguto.
Was that a long distance from your home, and was that an exciting kind of adventure for you?
The gala number to shusa gi lumba ne tha ring lu re thanda lobra la chong phe di ga ne
da ya den lo ro wa ya den lo ro ba je pa je su se ni ma ni ni ma ju shi de da pa to ko ro ni
so we went driving the yaks, and it took 7 days to go and 7 days to return.
Were there any adventures along the way or any dangers along the way?
Ani ta nyemad dunes de pa chu phe gor wa dun dunes. En di kap le ya chik langa le nyanga chungu da wadin da chik da me da din de khari chungi chung su es.
Yo man ka da lungba ya jambo re chukko ma chawo su no mare to jambo re. An wa du du jambo la chala du wa mare ta da ando dun ta su de sa de ta de pe de du dun ni ma re da ta tu du du no ma ta 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 jambo du du wa mare. Ka po su ka do de pa do de du da da ki yo chu do de ke wa.
It was a very gentle region and there were no thieves around and we did not hurry on our journey but the animals grazed and then we just walked along.
It sounds like it was very tranquil and pleasant. So, could he explain, please, could you explain what you were bringing from the village? This is from the village, and what you were trying to get in trade to take back to the village?
And that Tongsep ne chala kine chala tak ya la chala gyam ne rwa la khare khare chala gyam ne handa khawra la pha khidu yo
phege khoran zo ge a wa se de khare ko se yo ni ma chura sha 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 ko mo la sha ko mo sha cha sha ale ale de sa ko se ale a no mo wa no mo tu tu wa de de khon zo nga yo wa kha de de ko se zo de zo mo zo wa de cha za cha de
We took whatever the orders were. It was like dry meat mm-hmm. and butter and cheese and other fur and other such materials.
And what did you bring back?
Any panetsu karinam piggy or anything, but in a
panetsu go that samba and a gemma. What did it do that? Don't see the source of it. I said, damnation is the other thing.
So from them we brought grains, sampa and peas, enough to last for 1 year.
Sampa and
peas. Peas.
And was this a village or a city that you, did you trade with local people or shops? How did you trade?
Any hundred. Shada, Mada, Chura, the Nam Piggy or Wa, Paget Tongsa did Tongangila Tongore, me mill part Tongore, and Tongsipala.
Mother Tongo the Tongsis Sharwa, Pagan and Uncle Dabor and Billy Boys from Narwa, from now the Pacquin Ware. Now the Penetu were the Nathan Nasharwa, Tama de la Boy, Tabu, the other two named Mother, but the church journey, Tong Tong doing the Demore, as a part, I take to talk to the day.
It's a very easy sort of trade because the demands were given earlier what they wanted. So whatever was the demand we took and then they already had what we needed ready.
But it sounds like you got enough grain for 1 year. Does that mean you only went once a year or did you go many times a year?
The trade was only once a year, and every time it was at the same time of the year. And then this has been going on for generations, and if we went there, the people over there, you know, we're very hospitable to us. And the same way, if they came to our village, we also were hospitable to them.
Mm-hmm. And what was the same time that you went every year?
And lotapa rish peya ge tuzu de tuzu khadire. was in the autumn.
In the autumn. Mm-hmm. And on the journey, did you walk or ride the axe, or can you tell us about, did you sleep in tents or under the sky?
Vale. Tatanda pedigane compa gamni pigiorenya, ya tam tam yagana shungire, and ya kurda upuni, singiore, gonda kande chigiore, tetan jabudi.
Hey, tamando de shasa degrua, shasa de tayasa, chuasa de degre, tele ando mundo kurbu, kurbu, and ya dotes no ba de. Antes ella estaba de su sabatán, ane toa de doma, con distancia, su don de gre. Ane joga, gordon de den, cha, sir, cha, don, ane cama que se ya, bonda, desabato sin tocha.
So, when we stopped overnight, we chose the best place where there was grass and water, plenty of water available. Then the yaks were unloaded, and then we put up a tent, and we lived in that, stayed in the tent, and in the morning we made tea. Drank tea, loaded the yaks, and then set off.
And about how many people were in the trading group, and were there women and children as well as men?
Baba, ane bu, ane agulah sumpah ni orang wah, jadi cakap tu beri. Ini mana bu cakap mana? Jadi cakap kalau tu beri, cakap tu aja. Ane ini mana bu tu tu nak diri, pun cakap tu mana?
The women and children did not go for trade. They stayed home, and from the 14 homes in the village, the fathers, the sons, or the uncles went on trade.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. And to go from a village where there are, oh, maybe 14 or 15 homes, and when you went to this other town, was it, how much bigger was it?
Ta gyana number 2 gi tongsep nalia ta mezan chushis ma shio marwa ta page pesa lungba jorwa chongla ya di chelu yore ji khande da ji yore
ya bo re ta de ya thomba su 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 rwa mezo su 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 chatang ta ta Musi cacing jari, mesti juga dengan kanga cakap jadi mana. Tumbal ni, pasal dah dengan tumbal jenis tu, pasal tumbal jenis jenar apa, dah cuci dah sahaja tungsho cakap pasal dah cuci. Kalau pada pun dah rasa rasa ni dia. Jadi kanga gini.
So we face no problems whatsoever because these 14 families from my village, when they reach the other town, we would all go into different 14 other different families who would receive us. And this has been going on for generations.
Was the town that you went to also the same size as yours, or was it much bigger?
Tanda tongla pesa ges lumba jorwa la. Di gala number 2 ki tongsib le che yore, yang chikpa dawre kandre.
Te dachi re, kon te dachi yore. Ane singa de yorwa, singa de dachi mushi re. Manzo ta talante, mutu je risha darwa.
So it was much bigger, and they also had agricultural lands and big open spaces, but while where we came from, it was mostly hills.
Mostly hills. So besides trading and getting exchanges that were necessary, were there other purposes for such a journey? For instance, could a father be looking for a husband for his daughter, or to get some teachings from the monastery? Were there other reasons that would occur in this trade journey?
Tanda chongla pediu gane rwala. Tanda chikta miyu chongla pegi yorwa. Ine ya tanda shemba dinde yorwe chik gomba la peya drabu dinde ta yan chik nama makpa longya drabu dinde ta dinde gi tanda le dinde pegi yorwe.
Yes,
there were special festivals that we went to well dressed, you know, with very good clothes and ornaments, and then we attended festivals, ceremonies, and there were also talks about, you know, like brides and bridegrooms and marriages being arranged.
So you attended these festivals in October, in autumn when you went, or would you go at another time? Would the village take people at another time?
Tanda diyor wala tanda. Gunga mara tunga leya tanda chong la pigi yor wa. Tanda chong ba shenba di leya. Isi di hobra wa. Hobra chong la pigi gane. Di gab leya tanda ane kaza zebu dunzu yungu chigi yore. Yang tuzu shenba le yang dugu yore. Tuzu tanda chong mayimba.
Chong mayimba tuzu shenba le mada. Di gada ya di gwa mara chong kora kano mara. Tadi tuzu di losa bedam dela. Ane naga di kato kapsule.
So it was not during the trades that we had the festivals, and the festivals were during other times when we went.
And the village would go, people from the village.
And in the Losa that in the Leyan Tongsipa gave me the Zupa Duguroa Tongba Leyan. So people visited the other towns very rarely because of the distance, but if there was a marriage and if a woman was being married into Hobra, the other village, then people would go and attend the marriage.
And how was your village structured? Was there a leader for your village, and who elected the leader?
Ani kala nama tsonge tonsib la ya ta pembu yorwala. Ani pembu di sugi kusha chigore.
Pumba de dana asimja rambagu wejere. Anzo rame mesele. Asimja rambagu sirwa. Amakala nama sunda kwa kushun kawa tawa shungu ta nje tare.
The leader of our village is the Ramba family. He was a minister in the Tibetan government,
mm-hmm.
and we were tenants of his estate.
Of his estate, I see. And what did it mean to be a tenant of his estate?
Ta simsha Ramba ki ta dirwa ta. Miserva, the Missy, and you can candida with your Mission Baji, Missy Chiconi de Gugane.
The Tetchin Jow, Tetchin Romare, Tetchin Jow, I did a court pardon, Lotaja, Bonne, Mesosus, Kalet, Jabo Sharwa, I did Gijashi Shadi, Lotaja, Tetch our Ray, Tetchin with the Marie, San Jerome Messite, Sindan and Tashu did it.
So it was a very small tax that each family was allotted, and we paid that tax. And it is said that the tenants of this Ramba family, it was the taxes were one of the lowest, and its people were happy.
So each village leader would decide what the taxes should be.
The taxes were decided by the Ramba Dzong,
mm-hmm.
and it was a written law that since many generations that each family had to pay such and such a tax.
That
So in return, the Ramba family, every 3 years, each family was allotted 1,000 sheep by the family, Ramba family.
Mm-hmm.
And then the family who received the 1,000 sheep had to look after these sheep for 3 years. And if there was any increase or any decrease, it was up to you. Any increase was yours.
Mm-hmm.
Any decrease, you have to pay the family 1,000 sheep. So if there was a good fortune in a family, the sheep would increase manifold,
yes.
And then you could keep all the sheep.
All the sheep.
Yeah, and there were 4 or 5 such families there.
Your village sounds like it was very peaceful, and you did regular trade and you went for festivals. When did your village life begin to change?
Ane ang galagi tanda transit dita kibu shuwi jida wuj tanda tsuko dos rwa jika tongla pe semjin ta dili jin shuwi yorwa ta di changma gyuwa kadu joya gozu uswes
ta di gyuwa di gyami lene ane gyuwa tene kya kundai lene gyuwa tene
it changed after the Chinese arrived.
When did they arrive in your village?
Ane galagi transit nala gyami tsu kadu le uswes. They were already in our village by
1957-58. And what happened in your village as a result of their arrival? What changed?
Ani gami transit na le diu gani ani gua jo transit na gua kari jo swes. The Chinese were very deceptive. When they first came, you know, they brought sweets for the children. And then they brought flasks and other gifts for the parents, so much so that, you know, the children and parents were very happy when the Chinese arrived first.
Mm.
The Chinese officials who came to Tibet were advised by their superiors that the Tibetans can be given as many silver coins as you want to give them, because in the end you will get all the coins back from them.
Mm-hmm. How did he hear this statement?
So I lived with the Chinese for 2 years and I saw and I heard what they did.
Oh, well, why don't you tell us what you heard and saw?
Then after that, for 1 year, the Chinese, they made the servants into the employers and the employers into the servants.
Mm. And how did the servants feel when they were made the employers? What was their reaction?
Yopo dunzu pembu sero, jinda sero, aka kemi. Tende sudu gane, and yopo dunzu gi samlo laya, tachi lapsan candida, which the chungina, kunzugi.
Takondo, condo rango, de chena, and damasena, condoria, condoria, nida, orwa. Ta tamze gozo tachera. Tambo de deje, and de sugar, and the mechanical is in the ta. Puzo ya denitin, pame de ta, yamisha dansare, tacharandu and manzuke beta.
So the servants had no freedom. They had to do whatever the Chinese told them to do. And then later, the Chinese taught the children that your parents have suppressed you for a very long time. And now it's time for you to publicly humiliate your parents.
And how did they make the children publicly humiliate their parents?
And it pulled a so the Pama Tamsing Tango Laura, the country teachers.
That day and that Koronzo get Chase, you just heard what did in that Jodu Chanashani. That did Machana and Chanado and Yavatao Tang is the Chavina and Chanado Yamba Denetrains. What did it in that for Samadan? He messes her mother.
The children were forced by the Chinese to do that. That if they didn't do it, they would be punished.
And what were the children forced to do?
And it put so like kare zewan tang ne chijure yamige.
What actions?
Kare chijure pamale ya.
Da pamala kasana kondo da. Pamaga da dende ge dubu tang ma ro. Ta chana kema sun da pamaya yago cheyo ma res.
So the children were told that you will be the winners if you say that your parents have ill-treated you, and then we will support you. And then like for example, if a family had no children, if another family had 10 children, the properties of the other family were divided according to the number of people in a family. So that's the liberation that they brought about.
And what happened to the people who owned more property? What became of them?
So the Chinese divided everything equally according to the number of family members. So those poor families who had a large number of children, they received a lot of wealth and they became very rich. But as always, the poor have no fortune and they lose everything later.
Mm-hmm. And did the rich families still remain in their homes? What happened to them?
And in Michuku Dunzo Yaso Susu Nangla De Chure Kunzu Kari Chare.
That's
So most of the rich people became the servants, or if some of the rich were not willing to share their properties, then they were labeled as rebels and they were imprisoned. And later they were brought for public humiliations.
Can you tell us what the public humiliations were like?
네, 탐진 근주 간대도 갸라 직송다 사 탐진 당당한테 간대 치드웨스
다 탐진 당당한테 안 그런 거 시에 저도 많이 알아 아도 많이 듣은 다데 니야마 손스 되네 아 가서다 빵고로와 두응을 미쪼가 들었다 한 그만 되게 요거 다 원나 로로고 되야 어 된돌이 야 되네 콘도가 인연과 내 야가 몸부터 있어
他们当时，他怎么住下来？因为是什么？他怎么过来的？这里是我那，怎么住下来？怎么的呢？他们是当地的，他们是当地的。当地的，马家刚刚迁出去，那过来的人把咱这地产的，那前面是那，迁出去的，他告诉我，工作不大，工作没做了哇，他不开门的两个人的，马家的钱是哪个？我这里就安排的，他怎么做的？ The poor and those who were servants earlier, they were paid bribes by the Chinese, and there were lists of crimes that the rich people had never committed, and they were listed down. And then the rich people during the public humiliations, he had to accept all the crimes that were listed there, even if he had never done that. And then after accepting the crimes, he was imprisoned.
And did you see with your own eyes what the public humiliations involved?
Since I was a child, I did not attend any of the Tamzin sessions. But you know, when the family gathered together in the evenings, everybody used to talk about what happened that day. And then I also heard that some people who were to be tamzined the next day would be found dead by, you know, stabbing themselves.
Can you remember as a child what kind of feelings you had when you heard about these stories?
So the thought in my mind was, when can I escape to India? Because I knew I could never lead my life like this. And then there was a leader in our village, and he was dead, but his wife and two daughters were there. And these three ladies were to be had to go under the public humiliation, but they were able to escape the night earlier. So the next day, when the tamzin was to be done, so what the Chinese did was they brought three stones to symbolize three women, mm-hmm. and then they put paper hats on these thrones, these three stones. Mm-hmm. However, the ladies were able to escape into India, and I heard later that the mother was dead.
Mm. You mentioned that some people who heard they were going to be thousand were found, they committed suicide. Did you know any of these people by name?
Galagi Koyalaya, the Mikashi, Sanye, Tamsin, Taya, Risi, Dugan, Gonda, Sosu, Rangshi, Yang, and the Chungdua. In a Galagi, meeting the Moshing, you know, consuming
Ming the Kakashi.
Yes, I know, I know the donor names.
Dante Pier in Korokora, Chichan, Chang, and Jorova, but the Koram, the Mister Dimon Jura said it.
No,
Mister Koram Mingla, Jungru,
Jungru,
Jungru, Koram,
Jungru,
Koram Mingla, Kunju, Tebese, Kunju, Tebe.
Yes, the man who stabbed himself, he is from the Jungru family and his name was Kunchok Sevel.
Before these people that you described committed suicide, was suicide used by people who were upset in your village or in other Tibetan villages?
The Ranshi Gavish Yorwa, the Gami Lenita, Tamsin Tangris, Dugana, Ranshi Gaverwa, being one lasus you tongue said Naliata, Midendela, Dukang, the Mambu Yungurwa, the Jacob Lea, Ranshi Gab, Layat over the day, your own.
Don't join your money. On hold, no money. You money. No more of the message, she did cover it. I'll get your money.
Nobody had ever heard of suicides before. It came into being only after the Chinese arrived.
Uh-huh. And why do you think these people took their own lives?
Ane gala sambala ta kunzu gi su 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 rang shi gyab ni ta su 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 so su su tat mev su gyo rwa. Di kare chene chi gu tu re sangi du esa.
Tate kuron pe te shi gu jing na ju chabu tanga samne. An tat na ju di nyon lep su 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 rang su jane de tanga chung na sam. Tat dide na ujine kuzun rang jabu la.
So the reason they committed suicide was the fear of, you know, suffering, great suffering. Because since they wanted to avoid the fear of, avoid great suffering, they took their own lives. Because the Chinese don't kill you instantly, they make you suffer a long time by putting nails into your fingers and breaking your bones, and they make you, you know, half dead. You know, you just have breath in your body, but you are dead. Mm-hmm. So in order to avoid all that, they take their lives.
And what would be the Buddhist teachings in response to someone who took their life to avoid suffering?
Ta ngazu nangwa sangye gi che na la ro. Ta chi dungge kangye nyangri samne susu gi ta so 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 se gi yorwa. Ne de chungba na ngazu che na ta dela khari si ju ta khari khari khande ji yor ta dela.
Ta de ngone chine ta so so ta ji dai she de chine pe de rangsa de je na ne chlong ga pya de rangsa je de wo de de. So na me se de se ma ji dan de ko
So it is said orally, you know, mentioned that if you kill yourself, then you have to suffer the whole thing for 500 lives.
Mm.
But that is not there in the Buddhist scripture. It's just people say that.
So what else changed? You were about, when this was going on, this public humiliation and everything, you were about 14, 15 years old. If that's so, what else do you remember changed in your village? What happened to the monastery? What happened to the rest of your village?
That 다 담당하지
갸밀레
베캅라 다 교와 조여와 에네 곰바 타장라 카리 충레 셴바 교와 카리 카리 조여레
또 누구 다 다는데 요 같아요 말에 에다 다라 곰바 다 바다 자도 단사리 요 말제 다바 강가를 쳐다도 사레 아니 아 다 데 곰바 콜 신지지 마 친구 말에 띠가 통과수 되미 되미 통과시 아니 곰바 좀 도가 요라 님마미 다시 아니
The monastery was destroyed, but the monks' dormitories were made into prisons, and in the hall, the Chinese army lived.
And where had the monks gone, and when did they leave?
아니 잡아 던져 가디 가와 친구 잡아 참아
잡아 주제대 당한 거래 주식 강도 근데 당한 겁니다 쇼 생각이 없다 소속의 계급 쇼도 월다 배대 강가 토지다 코란도 배 다 랑성도네 배들 난다 메스다 배들 그때 마실 돈 돈이 있으니 아가 배대 당한 된 것이 아니 다 경고하는 게 뭐도 드라마요 말다 도산 그러니까 배 당한 거래 뜻은 좋게요 다 할려고 생겨요 오늘 전에
So except for a few very old monks, most of the monks had volunteered and gone to join the resistance force in order to defend Tibet.
And how far was your village from Lhasa, walking? How far?
Galage Tongsep di Lhasa ne tha ring lu yore ji komba gyan drogo chungba ina.
Lhasa ne modra shoge ta chudu dumbo ato thamba ina, onda chudu dumbo gyaba teru sikwa.
If one travels by a vehicle, say from 7 o'clock you left Lhasa, you reached my village around 7 or 8 that evening.
That evening. Mm-hmm. And the people, the monks that joined the Chushigan group, where did they go? To what part of Tibet did they go to join the forces?
Ane gyalang gombe gi thaba dun Chushigan du le ya zu do ro wa thang lang chi ni.
Di
sa ja khawa yo re thang da. It was at Hoga Tikutang that the Chushigandu was first established. However, the encounters took place at many regions.
Uh-huh.
It was at Setang, it happened also at Hobra Thuazong,
uh-huh.
and many other places. I heard from some fighters who returned that the encounters at Hora Thuazong happened between the Chinese and the monks.
Mm.
And the monks were not armed, they only had knives, swords, but the Chinese were not close enough for them to draw the swords. So what the monks did was they, you know, threw stones and were able to kill quite a number of Chinese. Hora Thuazong has many steep mountains and the monks were right on top of the mountains where the Chinese convoys were passing below, so they rolled down huge boulders on top of the Chinese.
Were these the monks from the monastery in your village that joined?
And the rikane ma dori dinge thabayorwa tunzu gyala gomba dine rewela. The monks were not only from my monastery, they were monks from many other
from
different
many
monasteries, and everyone had gathered from many areas.
Did many, in your village, you only said you had 12, I think, homes, maybe 12, 14 homes. How many men from the village joined the Chushigandru?
Mm-hmm.
아니 갤라기 통셉 나네르와 타바츠 더 페르와 이네 미마 나네 엔 쿄가 가즈지지 이네 주주간도 징가 페요레
어 다데네 메자 가셴나네 다 바제 메자 데네 메르 몬도 메세르데 메자 줄이야 다 포숨요나 아니 본인데 그 타는 거에 그걸 본도레
at least one person from each family
really
yeah where there were three sons at least two sons joined the volunteer force
And what about from your family?
And Galagi Nantane Susu Pere.
What do not Junju Shadarwa? Did they have
So, in my family, all the children were quite young, so none of us could join the volunteer force.
Yeah. How did your mother and father react, and how did they feel with this, the Chinese involved in your village? What was their reaction?
Ane dikabla galagi pala amala chogirwa ta lungbena le gamile de de chidi gane ane khoran soge in samdan khade chungare
ta konso de da bugun ngure san de de seben na la ngang ra da che na de mo ta tapche ke je
so they had fear in their mind that they would be much suffering later but there was nothing they could do about it
they were worried Is there anything else that you could tell us about what happened regarding the Chinese coming into your area that we haven't asked you yet?
Ani tanganzu gi keje tia lhab cherwa.
En
gyala sunya yonge dende ta gyami gyala ge chongbe nala lerwa chongsep nala. En di kabla ani khare khare chungyo re. Khatsin gyala ge sunya jigla ya jig
サトゥニミベヤドでソンソンだからでたんだそうそうだでかすねだまずもごらんてまれ単にこれ荷物で走りこれで思ってわでなりあねパマニでで東部パマニパマニ東部でパマニでパマニでなるそばのだでがねたらたらよしゃるわでたらでだミス
Ini kala tanda cik sungai di dina la tu minde yang gyo ci soro nanda.
Da konzo de kasena paman ni la sa to ga zu an paman sa de de sa do cha de an de na la de ne paman ni de so mo ko ron de lu da de na an ta la ga de ta la ga na bo de de la ne de ga na sha bo ta ro che da mo ro se an da su su paman de se de so ga da mo ro wa da de mo da bo li ya de ne
So this happened at a village nearby, not in my village, but I heard that a couple was asked to dig a pit, and then they were put into the pit, and the pit was covered, and their children were told to sing and dance on their parents, on the pit. And when the children refused to do it, they were beaten by the Chinese, saying that you are not obeying when we order you to do something. Such terrible things happened, which has never happened anywhere in the world.
Mm-hmm. Yes. ただ、論上単語単語です。たぼらでが彼チェズな。だで、ゴミをゴラでてね。あれ単語単語だ、これ、かそれ。たぼじょしゃげてら。みぷよろろ。たじんぼもてぷでろ。あれこでべ、メモンでね、ラン、アーチンどしね。ぺどしね。あれで、ゲミゴムじろ。で、サゴシュシャレ。ゲミゴムで。ゲムで、サゴシュザでね。たでにゃごからまれ。サインでぼでごんけだね。
누군가 So there was one incident that happened in my village. A thumbing was going on.
There was a very old man whose name was Dawa, and he was among those witnessing the Thamjin. And this old man, he just rushed up and then slapped the Chinese official who was sitting there. And then nothing happened that day to him. But the next day, Dawa was called to the Chinese office, and then he was questioned as to why he had slapped a Chinese official. And Dawa, he said, "I have suffered so much under the rebels that I was, you know, so angry that I didn't know you were a Chinese official, because I thought I was slapping a rebel. So I'm sorry for what I have done." And the Chinese, they were very pleased, and they made him a leader. And he was forgiven for what he had done.
So he fooled the Chinese, but he got to slap somebody.
So he was the Dawa was the winner, because deep down he did not like the Chinese. So during that Thamjin, when the Chinese officials said someone was volunteer and come and slap and beat the rebels, he stood up and slapped the Chinese, and he could slap the Chinese as well as he got a promotion.
Do you remember what he was like when he became a leader under the Chinese?
Ini jila mi dawa langi di tapi muchar wa kya mi wala. This tenya do kya la kengi ya kari char ko khande char.
Wo shu yo ko ya wo yo ko mo ko ran de dan den jo de ko ran chen de kara. Pe ma se khu je kya ba. Kam ju de kya ba shara de. Na ba na kam ju tu ro ba ko ma ra de wo re. Kam ju de kam ju da tem ga kam de mi shen da ko ma ra de se. An kam ju jang ko chen ju wo re. Ko kam ju da de ko
Yes, I know him. He's a very nice man, but he is a very good speaker. And you know, during conflicts, normally people asked him to make a decision because he was that intelligent.
I see. He was a leader of the village.
He was from a poor family, but he was a very good man.
Gifted man. So, who were some of the people who inspired you during these difficult times, and why did they inspire you?
Ani ta thuzu ta kange chimbu dine thong rwa gyan la en di kable ya ani gyan la ge ani su gi gyan la ya chik semshu dra wu ji te swe semshu ni ba ta su su kange dolen chi tu ya le ya
ta de phama ge de ge ba la wi dama ji me se de ma de de la ro chu ji ro ba ta phama ge ta ji pe a da de chi ju ru mu de de sha na an de ya ka yo ma re pa ta 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 bi chi ne chu don de ge ta ji ji che And the Pama Koran hit the Yamdo Yachia, Hanzo Ashan and Jure, Ashan Damitzuja, Ogota Jinta, Sanyetan Zongan, so they watch it there. And Tama Dosin Pama, Pama Nida, Jojo Aja, Napo Tore. Tama Nira Choto Madaina, that Jamig Loga Tunita, Yamataja for a poor Hanus, for the dead. Tajit Shabu Jones, Yamu Nan de Goma, little Tundo. And
So as I was very young, it was my parents who looked after me and then who planned my escape. It was such that, you know, the Chinese were sending all the young children to school, so my parents did not want to send me to school, and for about 15 days I was, you know, hiding up in the hills during the daytime so the Chinese would not come and take me to school. And then my parents said, you know, that you have to make your escape earlier, and they were not able to escape. But a brother-in-law of mine, who was a Chinese official, and due to some mistake, you know, he was about to be imprisoned, so he was going to escape, and my parents sent me with him, and that was how I was able to escape, why my parents and my brother and sister were left behind. So until a few years back, I was able to communicate with them, but now I have no contact with them. But I know that my parents and my brother are no more.
That's very sad. Did you? What was the journey like with your brother-in-law? What was that journey like?
Ane kela ajagi kyoan yamdo trepelwa.
No.
And the trepe kabli ya an langa na la kanye jabudin de kari chung suwe.
Oh, da la da la da gunga nam phana kadrawa. Ane kanga kanga da yungurwa. A bogo chungi su kumbasi ya tumen ya 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 ane hasa kyoan chenune.
So it was winter time when we escaped, and it was very cold. And since I was quite young, I couldn't walk into the snowy mountain pass, and so I rode a yak, and then we reached the Bhutanese border, and there was the Bhutanese border police who would not permit us to cross over, cross into the country. So they told us that we had to go back to Tibet. So then the women started weeping, and the men said if we went back, we would all be dead, so we might as well jump over the cliff.
Cut.
And so after 1 month, we were able to go into Bhutan.
So, when we left off, you were just, you had just escaped into Bhutan. And can we pick it up from there? What happens next?
Thank you, Nganzo Zam Shadi Gane, any Gala Dupe Gi police don't you get that? Do you know so tang roa, that was chick jela? That do you know so lay roa? Any carcere?
And this is Shajama Jagadane.
Ale, do you know Shajama Jagadane?
Jagada, Kuno, the name to the name, Gobakuronga, any. Sa jagama se ba dola ta ta shungi ma kontrol kaja perwa da ane koran to ke san na misha ma me ni ni ta ne pul si ni ni ta se ne an je je se je je do se ne an jagal pa den je je jagal je jagal ke chu te ne sa do ane ya nyam ni bo ne jagal jagal pul si ta ne ni ma te ka ko ma ja ma te yo ma re do te ke o ma je ma nam do da mo re se ka yo ma do te ba ko ni bo ne.
So after we got into Bhutan, the Bhutanese police, they escorted us, and then we came to India. And we were walking all the way and carrying our things on our back because there were no vehicles. Mm-hmm. So we walked all the way into India.
Oh my, how many days did it take you?
Mm-hmm.
So carrying our things on our back and walking, it took us about 25 days to reach India. And it was difficult because there were hardly any roads. And then if you looked up, you saw the sky. If you looked down, you saw the earth, because all around it was forest, thick forest. And we had to fear about the wild animals.
Yeah.
And at night, you know, we feared them so much that we burnt bamboos.
Yeah.
So that when the bamboos burst and made a popping sound, we knew the animals wouldn't come close to us.
Oh, very clever idea.
Mm-hmm.
When you were, your family wanted you to leave Tibet because the Chinese were taking children to schools. I wanted to first ask, did they take any Chinese in your village? Did they take any children to China?
Mm-hmm. Ganala lobdal tire sam shena chigiorwa dikable ya
ani
tinde pugu gyala ge thongsep ne tini ganal ma tinde mune nguyu tiya tinde chungyorwe
thore thore lobdal tu lu thambu ni bu thambu a chi sare tan ni bu sumbal ma de de ne tine lo thige se pugu paje ta sa ni pa lo bu pa phasam bu su do cha de ne pa tang ma tang gore
yes it's happened they had already taken the first batch to China. And they were gathering people for the second children for the second batch. You know, they if they when they had about 10 children, they made it into a group and then took them to China.
Do you know where they took the children to in China?
Ani pugo junzu ti ni gyana la ani kawa gyana ge saja kawa ti do ina.
Tata ha yo mare ko modern do ti de ta thu su la mo da saja de de ti de lo ka de tu de she ko she marwa. Na ka ga ni ha ko mare.
No, I have no idea where the children were taken because the Chinese don't tell the parents. And once the children were taken away in the vehicle, you don't know where they are taken.
Have you ever heard stories of children who returned after they were educated? Did they come back to Tibet? Do you know any children who were sent to China for an education and then returned to Tibet? No, I have not heard of anyone returning. Actually, we don't even know if the children were sent to school or killed by the Chinese and thrown into the rivers.
Right.
The
parents don't know anything. The only thing they did was worry about their children.
Oh, yes. And were children a certain number taken from each family or in the village? Does he have any idea of the number? Do you have any idea of the numbers?
Gyalagi rwa pugu khatsu thongsep dine ti yore gyalag khengi yona jik namgi re re ne pugu re re ti thu yona gyami dunzu khatsu ti yona
da de nga yahu shwesi zama re khaisa go da thongs dine duze 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 dine dine le chever sile amuji amjo ko de mudu da nga de kwa ti hebe parwa la shwem do.
No, I'm not clear about the number.
I'm not clear about the numbers, okay. So now you were walking through Bhutan with your brother-in-law, walking and many days, 25
days into India.
Ay, ay, ay. Did any of the Bhutanese people, how did they react to you when they saw you?
Gyala namba tsota nima ni senga tsota duyu rang la kumpa gyane ma pegi yorwa di dupa midin zugi ani gyala ta tanda peba mango yorwa thongdiyu gane khande raji chigdo khunzugi
ta de na zore kashe ge nin je sen ji chapa la ne gyen gore kashe ge da de ya de ba kasol pawa thong zama ge thong na da che na de che che ne che de ro che ba ma zu tanda ka kasol de ni 샤고 진다 안에 공신다 알아서 되거라 와 어디들 내가 공수 조서부터 농가도 농가도 이제 이제 스테도 가셔게 되고 따라 되는 냠도 동안 동들 보고도 깨자 좀 겸을 깨자 뭐 뭐라 시도 와 보고도 깨자 깨자 알고도 보다게 깨자 되는 아니 스타트도 역대도 아니 도도 내 사다다 진 대화 사다다 그래 어디들 내가
So there are many different types of reactions from the Bhutanese. You know, some were very kind. You know, they sympathized with us. They gave us tea and food. While others, they sort of feared us and would not come close to us. So once when we rested at a place, we went to beg from the villagers, Bhutanese villagers. And the elder people who were with us were too shy to beg aloud. You know, so they made us children to, you know, beg. And then when we did, there were some people who were very kind to us.
I see.
I don't know who's in your country. Good day, Cassare. Bangladesh, the Puchumu, who did your day. So, Sonsakora, Papu, woman and chills, or Papu. Oh, that is on the Shanachel, who's the Jumas Pamela, who's in Nigeria. That was the day, who the Chin has Mazan, the house of the church was the door, Yagan and Jara Osta.
The Bhutanese are Buddhists like us. And in the olden days, there were many Bhutanese who used to come and trade in Tibet. So in those days, you know, some of the Tibetans, they used to look down upon the Bhutanese people and consider them as lawless people.
Uh-huh.
And it was also used to say that the Bhutanese people who had baskets on their back used to kidnap children from Tibet and take them to Bhutan and make them work as coolies. So. You know, when the Bhutanese heard about these things, you know, so there were many who did not like the Tibetans.
Yes, I could see. Now, what happens after you go from through Bhutan to India? What happens when you arrive in India, and where do you arrive in India?
Gala number two, that do you ne ma perwa? Dine gyaral jorwa. Gyaral is such a kawal jore.
So there is the place called Thangla on the border of India and Bhutan. So from that area, I came to Baksa.
Mm-hmm.
And Baksa is the place where Mahatma Gandhi was imprisoned.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the place also where 1,500 monks resided.
Mm. And what was the reception like when you got to Baksa?
And Baksa la jorwa, and di kabla, and nelen tabu khande chido.
So the reception from the Indian government was excellent, you know. So there was food, there was clothes, everything for us.
That must have been a relief. You mentioned that when you reached some of the villages in Bhutan, that the children did some of the begging. So was your group larger than you and your brother-in-law?
Tangi gyala songya chebe yena tha dugyu nala ya chik longa phe u thurwa bikap la ya ani pugu din re longa long churwa ta gyamba cho ma long chi dugan gyala ta gyala gi aja khyoa ni che ko mare de mi mangbu yor we chala
yor haje au mi ngor tu ga da ju je che do ni yam du yor
yes there were quite a number of people about 56 in the group
so when you left with your brother-in-law you escaped Your parents wanted you to leave immediately. Did you join a large group or just the two of you go?
Ane gyanla gi pala amala gi gyanla gi aja khoga nyam do tang rwa. Didi mi ni che por wa. Ane mi manga dun zung ngap chung nga dang dun zu khawa thure.
Da du dong do chu do yong rwa. Ma du dong boye de 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 ha. Wa da zan na kar kar gan du ta lu ris ris de de ji ne sa bo che. Ai lu su de de zu mo she de ne wa de.
So when I left my village, there were about 10 in our group. Then gradually on the way, you know, because the valleys are very narrow and you meet a lot more people, and slowly our group increased into that figure. So the escape journey. So initially when we escaped and we reached into a mountain, there was no fear of the Chinese. But when we came towards Thadi, a town, we knew there were Chinese there was a Chinese army camp close by. So also there was a very, very huge river, you know, roaring sound from the river. And we knew that the Chinese wouldn't be able to hear us because of the roaring sound. But then we needed someone to guide us over the bridge. And it was a very, it was a hanging type of bridge. And our yaks had never crossed such a bridge before. And we had to pull the ring, on the nose of the yak to be able to cross the bridge, you know. And then for the guide, we paid him tampa and one yak to guide us over into the other territory.
How long was that? It was a rope bridge. How wide was it?
디 삼바 삼바 지어와 삼바 구조 단기 송이바 삼바 디 타링 류여레 삼바 링 류레
다지데
라오
그런 다시 모르다 아 주 담바스 아또 거기 담바 거기 담바도 아 또 서비스도 아 된다 거도 도고 이래 주 주 정신에 주바 덕주데 와 양마 초코를 깨 깨다기 기대라 다 삼바데 그 태자데다 바 바고서 자로와
The bridge was made of bamboo, and it was, you know, it was quite sturdy, I could say.
Mm-hmm.
But then it extended from like that, from that house till here. It was that big on a very, very huge river.
Over a river.
Mm-hmm.
Ah. Ooh. It sounds
very scary.
So there was a lot of fear, and some people also had dogs with them. So since if the dogs bark, the Chinese would know our presence. So all the dogs' mouths were covered.
Were covered.
Yeah, and until we crossed over the bridge.
So was this bridge near the border of Bhutan, and it was still in Tibet?
And the Samba Jiorwa, the Epeda Dupa Nige Sanzam La Yorwa. And that the Samba de Tule Tana do you let her? No, the river was in a place called Tari, and it is proper Tibet. So if you cross the bridge and then you reach a mountain, and if you crossed over the mountain, then you were in Bhutan.
Oh, I see.
You know, the crossing over the bridge seemed almost impossible. So we knew that it was only because of the blessings of His Holiness the Dalai Lama that we and the other Tibetans were able to cross over this bridge without the Chinese knowing, because their army camp was very, very close by, and in the night we could see the Chinese walking around with their torches, the flashlights. So there is another route you could take when you cross over from Tibet into Bhutan called the Lonangla. So there were many people who took this route, but then there was no bridge, and then in summer one could climb up steps that were carved on the rocks,
mm-hmm.
but in winter it was very slippery And our escape was around winter time, and many people slipped down and fell to their death.
Oh.
And in crossing the bridge, how many people were in his party at that time? And did they do it in the daytime or nighttime?
Ne, kyalang kyun sambadi ger wa sambad tari la sambadi ger yu kan di kab la ya ningung sambadi gang pere.
Sen sena ko, sena ko sa chuju chuju juni dele sambadi kadu ba kesi ko.
Mi mang le yore.
Mi pati ya dele da pati mi sun sora jore.
So we crossed the bridge at around 11 or 12 at night, and there were about 36 people in the group.
Yeah, that's very scary. I want to go back to Buxa. You arrived
Buxa.
In Buxa.
Buxa.
You said that you knew that Mahatma Gandhi had been in prison there. Did you know about Mahatma Gandhi? When you arrived or before, or did you just learn about him many years later?
And the galan kinzu baksar la perwa. And the galan sunya chinna the baksar saja dini ma Mahatma Gandhi zongan suyawa. And the galan ki dikabla Mahatma Gandhi kor thu nyo yuna. And Jesu chibu chibu la ya galan Mahatma Gandhi kor ken suye.
Da den he nama da hapu du yo marwa. De la pe. Mare, aga basa le rwa. Basa le tu den le Mahatma Gandhi nga ma inji zongan suyawa.
So I learned about it only when I reached Buxa, and then I learned that it was the prison built by the British. And I also saw the small cell where Mahatma Gandhi was imprisoned. Mm-hmm. And there is also a huge portrait of Mahatma Gandhi there. So there were about 1,500 monks, and they belonged to the four different sects of Buddhism, and they were also from the three great monasteries.
Mm-hmm.
And His Holiness formed this group because His Holiness thought that we could preserve the Tibetan Dharma by the monks staying together there
in one
place. And this was, you know, agreed by the Jawaharlal Nehru, the then Prime Minister of India at that time.
Okay. Interesting.
So Jawaharlal Nehru has been very kind to the Tibetans, but he has also made a mistake of saying that Tibet belonged to the Chinese. But then in 1962, the Chinese waged a war in India, on India.
Yes. What, since you understood something about Mahatma Gandhi, what do you think of Mahatma Gandhi and his work and his teachings?
Gyalata Mahatma Gandhi ko tis khengi yorwa. Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi ko tis khengi yorwa gyala. Mahatma Gandhi gita ta sungya ta dite ge korla ani gela khari sam gi dwes khuran ge cheje na ya ta tu ju korla ya
ta mahatma to koru tsme jo la de jamuro mi se ge ani chala na ma de mahatma gandhi rang gi de ni ka su ta shisha ge to ne de ni de ta ma to to ni korwa mahatma koru mi ta tsme jo ra mo ni ta koru mi to mu ji na pe su ji se ma ni che ge e koru ni de koru ja wa se
So His Holiness is advocating the way of non-violence as shown by the Mahatma Gandhi.
Mm-hmm.
By Mahatma Gandhi. But I believe Mahatma Gandhi was killed somewhere in Delhi.
Yes, it's true.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell us what happens after Buxa?
Mm-hmm.
What is the next experience in your life? Where do you go from there?
Ani kyanla di je ta baksa la phe rwa la.
En
baksa ki je la ani kyanla khawa phe re.
Oh, baksa ne ma doji ne do re.
Went to Darjeeling.
And what happened?
Doji ne la lokra la ta je rwa la ni sum ji de re la. Ebe se le kala she go chwa ma re. De de. Ani lo chu du na ta bache. Lo de na.
So I went to a school in Darjeeling for 2 to 3 years and just about learned the alphabets. And then I became a monk when I was at school at age about 17.
And what kind of a school did you go to in Darjeeling?
Darjeeling, gyala pesa lapta di lapta khandere. So at that time it was called the Tibetan Refugee School,
uh-huh.
But later it came to be known as a central school for Tibetans.
I see. And why did you feel you were only able to learn so little, like just the alphabet?
I became sick when I was there at the school. First from, you know, I had
syphilis?
No, fits.
Fits,
seizures. I suffered from seizures, and then when I got better, then again I had a problem with my legs. So when I first had the seizures, I was taken to a hospital in Darjeeling, but I did not get better.
Uh-huh.
And then I met a Tibetan doctor who inserted a golden needle into my head,
uh-huh.
And that's how I got better from the seizures.
I see.
But then unfortunately after 1 year, then I again was afflicted with pain in my legs.
In your legs. When you had the seizures, can you describe what happened? What kind of seizures they were?
And gela tanda riya gi naza di narwa la tambo. And di kabla khande khande chesue.
Tambo hoppa la da susu na do ibe ha ho ga. Ha ho do da ni le ge che sa ha do. No wo le le lung ya mo do lung lung de lung de tan se se le. A de ma ga u de tong ma de u ga ga ya tin do ga. A de da ba de 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 te me gen de ni. Di wa ka ga ji ha ho mo de. A ni te ma su de me ga ge che ga. Ho de da.
So you get to know when you're going to get the seizures,
yes.
Because you feel it coming,
mm-hmm.
You know, you feel air, you know, getting into your nose,
yes.
But you are not able to breathe out the air,
okay.
And then you collapse.
And you collapse.
And once you regain your consciousness, you are in hospital.
Right. And was he ever told, was there ever any kind of foaming at the mouth or his jaw was very tight, anything like that?
Gala tanda naza di nyung du gane rwa chikane boga jabu tenya ta chik tunsu chakbu jabu chaya dinde yung du e
boga ta tenya ta ga jira ta jim duwa boga ta tenya jire ta nga ta ko tumba jim du de ga ko tumba sabar tenya chata rwa ta jira
there might have been forms but I do not remember
Well, did the Tibetan physicians have any idea of what caused these seizures or what the name of the seizures were?
Ane phebe amjila dun zu gi rwa thanda na za ri de ya di khari chini na gi yeme din de ko la de she kyung du es
e de kan da me se ge kan da shi ra ma wa han na na de de zan ko la de se ge ja ta re sen de se ko ja la shu rwa de ma da me se de ko la ya kan de ji de de ta u chin ji ro ya de na wa cha ba ma de ta de 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 ko ri shu ro
I was quite young at that time, and I did not question about what caused it.
Right.
And so I just wanted that I should be healed.
Should be healed.
And if it was now, I definitely would have asked what the reason was.
Yes, yes. You were still quite young, and you were away from your mother and your family and Tibet. What kind of feelings were in your heart at this time in your life?
Tadi kablaya gela pala ama yomarwa chalaya ani phene pe tharin gurwa indi kablaya gela ge sembe na la ani samlo dawu ji khari khopi dos
de samana ta ne se ka khwes ge do ta su su ka da samba ba de dogwa haja ma bo nong sa ni de ne samba ko thap do cha ba de ne ka na de jira ga chong da jira ga samana de dongme de jira ta bo de ne ku ni ko
I had suffered so much that my heart was quite hardened and I did not think much.
I see. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Did you think that you would ever return to Tibet?
That is there every time in my mind, all the time in my mind.
In what way? Does he want, do you wish to go back or you would? You wonder if you will go back.
Ane gala sembe na la roa. Ha li gi yona da bu sang gi yore pa pa pheni thugo de phe la.
Do yo tu ne ane ta ji gam do de me tu go la. Me de ta ta ji na kang ba ba de ja ta ta sa ga ma de kang ne chi mo de do. Ane kang ba o ta de de he ta ta ji do do mo de ya chi tu na ha so da chi pa de ya ta jo na chung do ane ta ji ma da. Ta do ta ya ta
I wish to go back to Tibet, but I know that it's not possible with my leg.
I see. And when the Tibetan doctor, was it a lama or a doctor? It was a.
Gela handa serkap yamye jiorwa di thavare mjiranre mikumare.
Thavamare kumare.
A layman doctor.
A layman.
He was a very high doctor right from Tibet.
I see.
He was appointed as the doctor for the 1,500 monks in Bangsa.
So was this rod that was put in your head, where did they put it in, and was it like acupuncture or something similar?
Ani gyala la ya khap chi zu ruwa go le ya khap di go ne sa cha khawa la zu re chi khisa nga zu duwa la khap ta ta chi zu ra di ma ra
this silver ra re ta sa ga de khan de sa de 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 ko te no go ruwa te no de bet bet ma ga pa pa ru go zu ruwa ta de go de ya de do ma do to ji de de do de ya de ne pa ma pa sa ta de ba ta pa ma de zu do zu do wa
na
Sure.
No, it's not acupuncture. It's a type of golden needle which is pierced into the top of the head, and the nail, the
tip of the nail.
Not tip of the tip of the nail is pierced into the head, and the head of the nail is covered with in Tibet it used to be covered with a substance called pa, but here in India you don't get pa, so they cover it with a Tibetan paper, a type of paper made in Tibet, and this paper is set on fire, and the needle is slowly injected into your head, and as the fire burns, the needle heats up, and the heat is penetrated into your brain.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how it works. And then afterwards, the needle just jumps, ejects out of your head.
Mm-hmm. Does he remember how, do you remember how it felt?
Ani kala tengi do adikabla ani chana khari chungbe khane chuse. Yeah, I remember you have to bear the pain. So as the needle is penetrated, the doctor also chants a mantra, and once the needle is used, it can be reused.
Mm-hmm. Okay, it can.
It can be reused.
And then that took care of, you had no more seizures after that, is that correct?
And DJ la gala yangu ria de che nyung yo mare.
Ane beta, lo sum de de la. Kuzuma disega de 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 de.
I was completely cured after the golden needle.
And then the next illness that befell you, what was that called? The leg.
Ani dije le yang gala nyung shi chenba ji chung suwa.
De goma na.
La di na za di ming la khare gala khari nyung re gala.
Ah, wa zo pa ve zhen na da ta ji chu na zhe ba. Yo ko chu se da cha chi ji. Ani ji ka da ma zo chi lu zhen na bon ji ru go na. Bon ji.
Bon ji.
Right.
It was called bone TB.
Yeah. Okay.
So we now are, you said that you decided to join the monastery. What made you make that decision?
So my parents were in Tibet. You know, normally if you wanted to become a monk, you had to get the permission from your parents, but my parents were not there with me, you know, so
uh-huh.
I just, you know, took the decision myself.
Uh-huh. And what was in your heart that made you want to be a monk?
And gyalagi sembe nala rwa, and taba chini choya la kari chungsue gyala. Ta taba chigo samya chiyo rwa, di kari chere gyala, kari chene.
That is the one thing that so taba chene da, the
So I felt that life as a monk was much easier. Of course, in a way, if you really went deeply into the scriptures, you have to learn a lot. But then I felt that as a lay person, you know, there are more difficulties you face in the world with a wife and children and so on. And that's why I thought, you know, life would be much easier as a monk.
Did you feel it would be easier because you had suffered an illness and it left your leg somewhat damaged? Is that why it would be easier for you?
Ani galagi sembena la thiana rwa dikable ya ta chi susugi ta natsa na ani kangbala kyun shor de de cherwa chi mizi khari ene ge ta thaba chini de we na tis lel ha your is de de gong suwe sa
de nga thaba cheta ta la kangba ta thanda de na no ma ra de nga go tu de thaba cherwa kama de lo ni zebji la go tu.
So when I became a monk at 17, I did not have problems with my leg.
Uh-huh.
So it was only when I was 24 that
uh-huh.
I had the illness.
Illness, I see. And so when you left, where did you become a monk? In Desjardins or did you come here to De Geerling?
gyala thaba chidi gane thidi gyala dajibing shudu re de gomba la pesa.
Ma,
So at that time when I became a monk, I was at Darjeeling school. In one day, about 76 boys joined the monastery. Became monks in one day.
In one day. Mm-hmm. And did you stay in the Darjeeling for a long time and then come here? When did you come here?
And gyala Darjeeling la gyur rinpo shurwe, de ma peshare la san Darjeeling ne.
Darjeeling te de, tene ma kama na, ane Darjeeling la, Darjeeling la, nyo sun tu kore, ene ene shuwa tene, wile la, ane kasa la, menju chido la, kore ke san de.
De la?
De tamo de de ma re, de de shuku shuku da, na si ta na, na si ta, shiri, shiri ta re, shiri de gunde ta, Darjeeling da, shiri gunche wa, ma
So from Darjeeling, when I was afflicted, then I went to Dharamsala for a few years for medical treatment, Tibetan medical treatment. And then from Dharamsala, since I was over age to join school, and they thought I was not well enough to work, so they said I should join the home for the aged in Darjeeling. That's how I came here.
Uh-huh. So, at what age did he come to the home for the aged?
Ne gela de la ka konglo ka du yin du pe yin be.
Gela dunju tunye de.
Chikdong gobyo dunju tunye de.
So
I came to the home for the aged in 1972. So I might have been about 20, between 28, 9 or 30.
And were there other monks here, and did you receive any teachings that monks usually receive?
Ane gyala de la perwa, de la pedu gane chik, ane duwala ya thaba shemba dinde duwe, ane gyala chik thabe lobchung dinde ra yorwe.
Ta de la hendu zane thaba mambu shirayu. Kudu kaa nye che, anzu kudu shibay na la ngambi samansi yore. Ane kudu choba de la, ane kada thaba nye gansu na thamu yin dinde zane, thaba ji kya samansi dinde yore. Gansu kora dhan dinde na ngambi samansi yore.
Napya. There were many monks when I came here. They were about 100, and totally there were about 500 elders here in the home for the aged. But now it's got reduced to 146, including the staff members.
Oh, I see. Okay. And do you have any special function that you perform here as part of the home as a monk?
Mm-hmm. Chaba yimbe chanerwa, ani gyala ki chik gyan chabe ki chida dinde zegudan dinde nangi yuna.
Uma ondo de da chaba ondo mongol du zane, ondo de kanga tu cho kwa de zine sasa tu zane, ane shim shembe che, ane shio zane, ondo go de go zane, chidu de go, chaba kasa saka da wala ondo da de donga chidu de udu kuri shiba jo gore, donga chidu de, ane chidu de zane, ane chidu de zane, ane chidu de zane, ane chidu de
Mm-hmm. So earlier when there were many monks from Tibet here, so we used to perform pujas on very special days, but now everything is closed because all the monks are gone.
But what do you think is the role or the function of monks in the Tibetan culture?
Tanganzu pewegi rikshu yorwala rishu nala ya chik en thaba lama choge ene mimangi thandala chik khare khare chigi yores
ta mema dunang ti namjo ge ta pa ba ge te je tane ne ji ta won do tsechi ma ge ne ji ge lama kondala ji ge ta kyong ge chada do to ge ba wan de ji ma ba
So the role of the monks is to teach the people about the Dharma and about this life and the next.
So what do you hope will be preserved about Tibet for generations to come?
Gyalagi rewala rwa, tanganzu gi pewe gi ta lo shunbe tendala rwa, tanganzu tanda ne kari sungyab chigu yore.
Ta gondzo la maungba da nga zo gong di shung ta chungbo de, gong chwe nangba sange chwe de, yangwa di chungbo ta bebe zangbo de le de le chab chungbo chungwa re, What is it? I'm sure I'm going to visit the stage. What is it? I'm going to go to the stage. I'm going to go to the stage.
So it is very important to preserve our culture and the Dharma for the future generation. And that His Holiness is spreading our Dharma in the world. And the children must try to continue, you know, practicing the Dharma and learning about it. Because if a day comes that the Tibetan children have to ask the foreigners to teach them about the Dharma, it is a big shame.
So, in conclusion, what do you want the people around the world to know about Tibet? And what do you want them to do about Tibet?
Ane gyalagi samlo nala rwa ta jambulingi mi yorwa dunji gi phebe thendal ya khari chi chi gosare samgi de sa
ta ngazo a mi sai jure a gemi ane a ta dunju josun rwa ta ngazo tanda a phoba sai jude gemi dunju josun khade jude de la le ta ga de ta de ta ngazo de khade jue de khaisi ma du mun de be
The Tibetans are just 6 million, and these 6 million people are facing the 13 billion Chinese at present. So, because we have truth on our side, and I request the outside world to support us, because one day truth will prevail.
I want to ask just a couple questions. If this interview was shown in Tibet or China, would this be a problem for you?
No, there is no problem. So I was very young when I left Tibet, and I grew up in India, so nobody knows me there.
Yeah, so no one knows you there. And can we use your real name for this project, or do you want to use an alias?
Galagi Ming Momang Anzu Peju Tangna Digiorwa. Ming Jibu Gyab Goya Dinde Yoma. You can use my own name.
Okay, great.